And we're back with another episode of Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind.
Of all the things I've gotten used to, food was the hardest adjustment.
I quite agree. Deer wouldn't oversalt everything and run it in sauce.
And they burn out all the flavor. Nothing like a raw deer flank.
Raw? You'll catch salmonella. Let's go into Odda's house. Last episode... It's funny because they start speaking exactly after I finish my little intro, speech, line, whatever you want to call it. It's like perfect timing. Anyway, last episode we killed a bunch of harassing thugs. We harassed them with our swords and spells, and they died from that. And we found a key on one of them to a house, which apparently we haven't been to because I have not found any houses of which I wasn't be able to get access to. We did get into a house here, which is not marked, and there were a bunch of harassing thugs and a named NPC just standing in there. And I kind of felt like, you know, should I just attack them? But, I'd have to hit A and manually attack. I'm surprised they didn't attack us, so I don't know if that was bugged or not. Maybe that's the key to this area and we weren't supposed to get inside there yet. I'm just guessing. So let's go into Odda's house, whoever the hell that is. I'm actually really enjoying Ondra's gift. It's pretty interesting. It's got a nice pirate wharf kind of thug theme going on. Are you hearing about my boy? A quiet, motionless shape is swaddled between filthy rags and moth-eaten towels. I guess that's your boy? That's my boy. A pale green fuzz has colonized one of the loaves. Ugh. Mead, I'll leave you to that. And sugar, you can keep that. An Odda. The woman looks like she hasn't slept in days. Her hair is a rat's nest of tangles, and her eyes are lined with shadows. She casts an anxious glance at the door. Her eyes widen somewhere between hope and apprehension. Are you here about Darren? Number four is funny. Who? My boy, Darren. His father, Wade, took him fishing 2 days ago, and I haven't seen either of them since. The neighbors are no help, and the city watch hardly bothers with the gift these days. This Wade sounds familiar. I'd be on the docks and looking myself, but I can't leave my baby. Her eyes wander to a crib, and she lowers her voice. I don't dare take a hollowborn out, what with the violence near the brothel. You have a hollowborn baby? The answer is etched plainly on her face. Widewind's legacy is as potent in Defiance Bay as anywhere. People are scared, and they're looking for someone to blame, whether it's those women at the brothel or the families of these poor babes. Idara says, it might be nice if a god or two stepped in and set people straight, but maybe that's just me. I don't approve of what goes on at Maya's place, but these attacks won't earn us the god's mercy. And it's only made it harder to earn a living. Tell me more about their disappearance. What do you want to know? Tell me about Darren. The ghost of a smile flickers across her lips. He's a brave lad, if a little too bold for his own good, but he's always been a dutiful son and a gentle brother. He's got dark hair, quick eyes, and a ready smile. When you find him, you'll recognize him in a heartbeat. I'm sure of it. Tell me about Wade. She scowls and brushes a greasy strand of hair from her face. Sometimes I don't know whether to rejoice or rue that he comes home as often as he does. He spends most of his time and all our money drinking at that brothel. Has ever since. Her gaze gestures to the silent cradle. Where did you see them last? Wade was taking Darren fishing at the docks. That was 2 days ago. I have no more questions. I'd be on the docks and looking myself, but I can't leave the baby. Yeah, we've seen that. I'll be back if I find anything. Odda closes her tired eyes, likely for the first time in 2 days. I don't know how to thank you. I don't have much to spare these days, but Ondra bless you for anything you can do. This Wade sounds familiar, though. I don't know where I heard about him. Too many people. Too many names. I'm not good with names. Surprised I remember names like Vianna and... What's his name at the forge? See? I don't remember his name. I've almost got it, though. If I heard it, I'd know it. I'd be like, that's him. That's the one. So have I been everywhere, then?
Sure.
You mean sure I have, or... or what? we're near this place, right? Have I been in here? I'm not sure.
Margrin's fire.
This is the people again.
Hail, traveler.
Huh. Now we can talk to her. Interesting. This is where I was talking about. With the, we just got in here and we didn't use a key, did we? She folds her arms over a dented breastplate. Yes? I'm here about the trouble at the Salty Mast. Ordinary kith are angry, as they should be with that crooked Omaur toddying up to the nobles. She sneers. She's using the tragedy of Widewind's legacy to line her pockets. She's no better than the Adirin overlords we drove out 200 years ago. People around here say you've got a good heart. Maya's made it so only the rich can afford her establishment, yet she sits in the poorest district of Defiance Bay. How's that right? You've taken matters into her own hands, but she's the real criminal here. Why don't you tell her to back down? We'll use our intellect. Maya might be making a fortune, but her employees aren't. You're hurting them even more. I hadn't thought of it that way. Her dulled pauldrons sag. Then I guess there's no point to this, is there? She looks at the thugs standing around her and finally nods. Tell Maya we'll leave her people alone. That's awesome! We resolved this without conflict. I love it. I love it.
Hail and well met.
You have an understanding about the brothel, right? Is there something else? Nope. We'll stay out of Maya's way as long as you stay out of ours. We live here. We just want to be treated fair-like. Awesome. We'll report back. Quest complete. Well, after we talk to her. I love this game, have I mentioned that? I don't love how it starts us over here. But somehow it knew we wanted to go here, right? Faster! Faster, slaves! Sometimes there's a purple dot there, and sometimes there isn't. I don't know if that's a glitch or what. Let's go check it out. Unless it is weird, it's like this hole in the ground. Oh, it's that thing down there. We've been there, too. We can talk to it? Is this a good idea? Definitely not a good idea to do it alone. Darren! A young boy's corpse lies at your feet, half covered in dirt and seaweed. His hands have stiffened around a dagger. A soul lingers nearby, something confused and lost in the seaside fog. Reach toward the soul. As you reach for the soul, it lashes out. Glowing mist strikes at the air around you. The soul can't touch you, but you feel it burn with a feeble, uncontrolled rage. It's okay. I'm here to help you. The soul flickers. It ripples toward you, timidly at first. As it swirls around you, you experience wonder, fear, and the joy of running between the ships at noon. With a jolt, it pulls you into the streets around the salty mast. Women with painted faces weave between men stumbling in and out of the lamplight. Father's gone in for a drink, just like always. He said he'd only be a few minutes, but it's been hours. The man guarding the door only laughed when you tried to explain this. He knows what he's up to. There's always a back door. In an alley, two men have cornered a woman. Her cheeks are streaked with tears. She's backed against the wall, and looking away, they're inching closer. You step forward. The men barely acknowledge you, but the woman looks at you, a plea in her eyes. You've seen that look in abused strays. In your hollow-born sister, that time father took her from her splintering cradle and to the filled washbasin. You were brave that day. A knife is in the thug's belt. It's in your hands, and now it's in his thigh. You're small and fast, but not fast enough. Fingers bite into your arm, and a muddy boot sails toward your face. Then everything is muffled by cold, brackish water. The soul retreats from you. It pulses with a question. You did a brave thing. The gods will reward you in the next life. Darren's soul absorbs this thought and ebbs in the ocean mists around the dock. A young boy's corpse lies at your feet, half covered in dirt and seaweed. His hands have stiffened around a dagger. Yeah. Take the dagger. The boy's small hands are rigid in death, but you pry the dagger free. It looks too large and too expensive to have belonged to him. The letter B is carved into the pommel. That's the initial for the one who killed him, because he stole his dagger. And I guess then he took it back and killed the boy with it. Or no, the boy, it was holding the dagger. The guy didn't bother to take his dagger back. Yeah, most likely belonged to Darren's killer. It's so funny because I'd look at this area and sometimes there would be a purple dot there and sometimes there wouldn't. How sad. Well, where's the father? That's what I want to know. And I guess we have to find the killer now. But first, let's stop in at the Salty Mast. I kind of like these local quests, you know, that we can just do quickly.
Greetings.
Always good to have a few more warm bodies in here. Any progress with those thugs? I talked with the ringleader. She's agreed to leave you alone. Maya's brow ridges rise. Well, that's a welcome surprise, and one worth celebrating. Take some coppers and enjoy yourself. Her smile widens. And if you choose to have your fun here, enjoy my special discount. Hayla says, you go ahead. Really. I'll just wait by the bar with a glass of something that kills disease. A knowing grin warps her blue markings. Now, just what can I do for a comely lass like yourself? That's it. Completed! Yay! Okay. No one has anything to say, no one's leveled up. Okay, let's go. Back to Odda. Reputations. I just saw a little tip about on the loading screen for reputations. Okay, so I can see it's a rank, so I have two ranks in benevolent and diplomatic, one rank in clever, stoic, aggressive, passionate, rational, and honest. Awesome. So we are neutral with Defiance Bay, overwhelmingly good champions with Gilded Veil, a faintly good ally for Knights of the Crucible, a faintly good ally for the Dozens. Dozens is going to go down eventually. And a troublemaker for faintly bad but has Dominel. That's so funny. Wow. I've spent over 24 hours, over 26 hours in combat. 455 enemies defeated. You know what? Any new entries with the bestiary? I haven't checked that out lately. Animats. Animats were initially created to serve as guardians for royal tombs. Their earliest creators, bound the souls of their strongest warriors and servants to intricate sculptures made of various materials in accordance to the rank of the soul captured within. As the knowledge of the technique for this process became more widespread, powerful animancers started creating their own animats to serve as personal guardians, using whatever weapons and materials lay at hand. Animats can only be created through the use of loyal souls that hold a powerful dedication to protecting their charges. While the ritual to create them can still be performed upon unwilling subjects, a lack of resolve in a participant's soul can result in abominations which immediately attempt to destroy themselves in a violent manner, often inflicting collateral damage in the process. Even successful creations remain vulnerable to the onset of doubt, and most animat creators take great care not to allow such doubts to manifest. And we fought those things in the water, right down there. Is there anything new here? I wish we could, filter them by, you know, how recently we discover them. That kind of thing. Pogres? Do we look these up? Yeah, we did. Rain Blights. Huh. These amorphous clouds, maybe we fought them down there with the, the animats. These amorphous clouds rapidly swirl with violent energy. Within the maelstrom, dozens of humanoid shapes materialize and vanish within an instant. Faces scream in silent agony while hands desperately clutch and claw at the air around the mast. Beowicks, spirit winds, as these storms are known, often create blights. If souls are ripped free of bodies and caught in the center of the storm, they may become stuck together and bonded with any other elemental substances in the maelstrom. They are pure chaos and confusion, and destroying them is considered a mercy to souls trapped within. Well, we have done so. Experimenting with blight creation is yet another questionable activity that has earned animancers a bad reputation in many circles. Some see it as dangerous and inhumane, others as a means to an end. The creation of blights is an accusation many fearful kith level at animancers. Revenant? Revenants are undead that have devolved beyond even the relative intelligence of a ghoul. Revenants retain their instinctive hunger, but they don't have the will or intelligence to reliably satisfy it. They are drawn to any environment where dead or dying bodies can be found. We haven't been fighting that much recently. We've just been exploring the city for forever. I do believe we have looked at these. I'm not sure if I've read this, so I'll read it. Young dragons begin their life cycle as worms, though most never devolve beyond that stage. Worms are clever and sly, if not especially intelligent. To develop into a drake, and eventually a dragon, a worm must have ample space and resources. They will not develop if they live near existing drakes and dragons. They must seek out a habitat that has not already been claimed by a larger counterpart. Since the chances of further development are low, most worms will band together in covens for survival. They are bold and highly aggressive creatures, if not particularly intelligent. The intense competition for food and territory demands this. Okay. Unfortunately, the Zorip descriptions for the priests and skirmishers and regular Zorips are all the same. This is hers, right? Yeah. Have you found my Darren yet? Oh my god, how callous. You may want to sit down. Darren won't be coming back. Ada's mouth falls open and she stares back in shock. My boy's dead? That can't be. What happened? Oh my god, that last one. Darren was defending one of the prostitutes from a couple of thugs. He was very brave, and you should be proud. She sobs and quickly brings a hand to her mouth. Her eyes are bright with tears. Gods, how could this make it any better? I would never let my boy die for one of those women. And yet... She chokes into her sleeve. I can only pray the gods will be kinder to him in the next life. Maybe there's hope for one of my children. After several seconds, she closes her eyes and swallows. I suppose it's better to know the truth than to keep wondering. Thank you, at least, for bringing me answers. Here, take these. I'd been saving several keepsakes for Darren one day, but he won't need them now, and I doubt I'll have another child to pass them on to. Where's this Wade? I guess, can we find him in the brothel? Task completed. Ada was crushed by the news that Darren was murdered, but at least she knows what happened to him. We can level up. Some of us can level up. We got a minor ring of protection and a fine dagger. Well, we'll sell the dagger. What is this stuff doing out here? I thought it was holding shift. Damn it. That's the fine dagger she just gave us. Don't mind the noise. Oh, that's that ring that guy gave us. Where's the ring she gave us? I don't want poultry. Where did I get this? Must have been a while ago. I'm sure I read it at that point. These are scrolls. Scrolls, books. He's got it. Plus 5 fortitude, reflex, and will. No, it's... that's protection. He's got deflection. Oh, she's got deflection, sorry. He's got protection and overseeing. I don't even know what that does. Overseeing? That's a spell, I guess? I don't know what that does. Unshackling and deflection. It's actually got overseeing already. He's not wearing any rings, so yeah, you take overseeing, kinda. Thank you! My poor boy. That's so sad. So what else do I have to do? You know what, I want to try the Salty Mast again. Let's see if we can find this Wade in here. I remember hearing about or talking to a Wade. Oh, we can also level up. Canna. He's really good with lore, isn't he? I think he's good enough, though. That'll use all his points to get to level 10. He fights a lot. Why don't we give him some athletics and survival? Paralyzes enemies in the area of effect. Conjures 3 worms into... ooh! Nice! Masses stray soul fragments to form 2 will-o-wisps that fight for the party. Well, we need soul fragments first to do that, right? Which means we have to kill 2 people and then we'll get them, I guess. Terrified. Defends against hobblestruck, paralyzed, and petrified effects. Stir something deep, charming them. Okay. I want worms. A new talent, Beloved Spirits. Improves the chanter's connection to the soul fragments they employ. Increasing Ancient Memory's healing ability. Modifies Ancient Memory. I don't have Ancient Memory, do I? What kind of weapon is he using? I noticed maybe his defenses we could help with, because he does get banged up really easily compared to Adair. Of course, he's not a pure warrior. Plus 10 reflex. Plus 10 fortitude. Plus 10 will. Shield deflection. Plus 5 deflection or... one of these. Will fortitude reflex. Well, that's plus 10 deflection, but decreases attack speed. This is plus 5 deflection. Let me take this. Superior deflection. Maybe it will stop getting hurt so quickly and banged up so much. Alright. Sure, Sagani. I don't have much experience with this kind of character. Look at her survival, it's through the roof. How about athletics? And athletics again. Yeah, take 3 ranks in athletics. Vicious Companion. Trains the ranger's animal companion in vicious tactics, making it deal more damage with each hit. Nice. Accurate wounding shot. Ranger's aim becomes deadlier, making his or her wounding shots more accurate. Plus 10 accuracy to that. Resilient Companion. The ranger's animal companion gains improved damage reductions against all damage types. Or Merciless. Small amounts of sneak attack damage against those that qualify for animal companions. We've never had it sneak attack. Let's give it vicious companion. Plus 15% damage. That'll help. I've only seen that thing die once, and that was when everyone died, so we'll do that. Done. Well, I don't want to do that. And last but not least, of course, Theodas. Bong! Let's take another athletics. Oh, more stuff here. Ectopsychic Echo. Fractured Volition. Puppet Master. Dominated by the cipher for the duration. A dominated target is subservient to the will of the enemy. We use everything at its disposal to fight its former teammates. Awesome. One at a time. And secret horrors. Their worst fears have been realized. Let's take it Puppet Master then. Talents. Biting Whip. The Cypher Soul Whip bites deeper, granting a bonus to damage, plus 20% damage. Psychic Backlash. Stuns an enemy whenever they target the Cypher's will defense. How often does that happen? Let's take Biting Whip. I try to avoid stuff that's overly specific. Why do you keep dragging me over here, game? Alright, let's go in. See if we can find Wade. Where are you? Mariko. I don't think it's any of these people.
How do you do?
So you're gonna ask her about this Wade guy. Captain Pepperjack. You know, maybe I'll do this another time. That's what you said last time you came here. I'm not listening to another week of you chafing in your drawers. Shh, someone will hear you. will like us? I sincerely hope so. Wade! Hey! You found your boy. Can't a man drink in peace? Tap him on the shoulder. His eyes are filled with shame and self-loathing. What do you want from me? Your son is dead. Darren was defending one of the women here from a couple of thugs. Wade seems to stare through you. My boy died while I was here? Odda, my wife, she always said I'd come to no good, but I never thought. Oh my god. I will not do number 5. Can you imagine that? I'm kind of wondering, kind of curious about seeing someone play through this with a complete jerk, a complete ass with all the responses as much as possible and see how that goes. You need to tell Odda what happened. What's the use? It's over. Our son is dead. She'll never have me back. This is where I belong. Just leave me alone. Oh, okay. That's a sad story. Okay. Going to call it an episode here. Thanks for watching. Tune back next time. I'm going to tackle some of these miscellaneous quests we've been gathering, the ones in town anyway. I'm not leaving, and then eventually we'll head back for this lighthouse of horrors here. Now that we've leveled up, maybe in completing some quests we'll level up some more people. I know there was something about this guy too, I remember that name too. Oh, yeah, and after the lighthouse I guess we're going on to Heritage Hill. Thanks for watching and enduring. Grow strong.